Hello everyone, I hope everything is good for you and you had a good and great and happy Easter. So I like, as some of you, I like to see the different videos on YouTube. So, but it's curious for me how some videos are really popular, and I saw one is hip hop Gangnam Style. It's like almost 3 billion of views. There's a lot of views. There is other, is about science and fate. I just had like a 120,000 views. So it's a huge difference. Now time to the people like to see this for entertainment. Do they like the music, different kind of music, and just looking for have a good good moment just seeing videos. But I don't know why the fate, the people, they don't look into much about documentals or things about the fate. If something is good for me and I'm really interested in something, I'm trying to looking for. So I don't know. Yeah, I'm asking to myself if the people really don't really are interested about the things about the faith. I'm not sure, but this video that I was telling you is really important. Is I'm going to put it on the descriptions. I'm going to copy and paste the link. So I will start with the Bible and Luke to put in context what I'm going to share. So then they brought him to Jesus, and they threw their own clothes on the colt, and they set Jesus on him, and as he won, many spread their clothes on the road. Then as he has now drawing near to the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with loud voice for all the mighty works they had seen, saying, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." And some of the Pharisees called to him from the crowd, "Teacher, rebuke your disciples." But he answered and said to them, "I tell you that if this should keep silent, the stone will immediately cry out." So here is it's really important how the Pharisees try to the disciples just silent about the faith, about the glorified Jesus Christ. And Jesus said, "Let them. If they don't say nothing, if they don't cry out, the stone will do it." So it's important how for Catholics, it's important the relics, it's about the clothes or the some signs wear it, or the host, the Eucharist, the shroud of Turin, and so many things related with the faith. Some Protestants, they think that these things are weird. They said, why the Catholics keep these things? But for the history of Catholicism, there's a lot of the articles or things, consecrate things that happen through miracles through the history. So on the Old Testament, you can see the serpent, Moses' serpent, and he the animal have the life and emerge the life became from the something with no life and something with a life, the serpent. So the Ark Covenant was a thing was consecrated. So they bear the Ark Covenant and they made a lot of bottles and God was with them. So there's a lot of things or consecrate things that God reveals. So this time, so the church, and it's really interesting how the church trying to cure those faith articles to the scientist to verify if those miracles are true or false, if there is some fakes or not. So the church, they permit some scientist groups to analyze different miracles. So not just because one bishop said this is a miracle or the priest say this, just they want something become a miracle. No, it's the church looking for the science to verify that those miracles. So this is one important thing in the faith, but not is the most important thing in the faith. Faith doesn't the most important in Jesus said through on the Bible, he said, don't believe. They don't believe in me, but they believe in the miracles that I did. So, as a humans, we're looking for something sensible, like miracles, like you can verify with your eyes, or you can touch things like that. We are looking because we don't believe, or probably we need some of us needs to verify with sensitive five with senses. So, for today. And it's really important in my life because I saw when I was a child, like 7 years old, I saw the Jesus of Nazareth, the movie, and when finished the movie, I remember I saw one little documental about the Shroud of Turin, this the cover or the blanket which cover Jesus, the burial cover of Jesus Christ, so his face, and they wrap it the body of Jesus Christ. So I was living in Wyoming and I was seeing a documental about the Shroud of Turin. It was really interesting for me and I pay attention about the subtitles and every graphics and every pictures, and I saw one part a little familiar close to in on the documental close to the Wyoming. So I'm looking for the credits and I saw the name of the center of Shroud of Turin located in Colorado Springs. So when I was over there, I say, oh, wow, it's close to here. And I spent like 6 hours in one car, a regular car. And I asked for some friends, say, why we don't try to looking for this guy, for John Jackson. And John Jackson was a member of group of scientists and examined the shroud of Turin in 1978. Was the first time the church, Catholic Church, permit scientists get try to examine the shroud of Turin by John Paul II. So was he was John Jackson. He was a scientist, and he was in this. He belonged to this group of scientists to verify about the authenticity of shroud of Turin. So this is something that is interesting for people who wants to verify it. I remember Saint Thomas, the disciple, needs something to prove him that Jesus Christ really resurrected. Was he saw Jesus Christ, he don't believe. He said, "If I don't touch the wounds and verify it, I don't believe." So Jesus appeared again, and he touched and put his hand in the hole of Jesus Christ. So here, close to the ribs. So this was our people from now times. We need a lot of people looking for verify these things. Usually the medias or the social medias, a lot of people like the conspiracies about the terrorities and different terrorities. You can see documentals about the fake or no authenticity of the Shroud of Turin, and a lot of people try to emulate or try to imitate the Shroud of Turin, but nobody can get how they did this. So the Shroud of Turin is one relic, and other is Sudarion Oviedo. Those things, those relics, when they put it one behind of the other, so the part of blood in one of the match with the other one. So when you put those together, there is the same blood, has some spots with blood, and the people who believe in Shroud of authenticity in about the Shroud of Turin, when they see those things, they look in different points of view how the people get and investigate and get some conclusions about the Shroud of Turin. But in 1988, they take some sample and they cut one on the corner of the Shroud of Turin. They split in four pieces and they sent to different laboratories in England and in Germany and in the United States, in two different places, and they test carbon taste. They taste those pieces, and the conclusion at this time was the Shroud of Turin was a fake, was a medieval fake. So a lot of people, they said there was disappointment for the veracity of the Shroud of Turin, but some of them, they keep believing in the Shroud of Turin. And when they found something weird in this sample. First of all, the sample was kind of dirty, and they found different materials like cotton, and they try to join those pieces, and probably in the 16th century, somebody, or probably nuns, they tried to put together to repair this part of the shroud of Turin. So when they put this, they put some cover or paint to match with the rest of the shroud of Turin. So this part was little contaminated. So one couple saw the documental, the I don't remember exactly, I think it's Raymond, was the one scientist that don't believe in the Shroud of Turin, and he test, they sent the test in different laboratories to verify that those date, the date 2000 years ago. So this, when they repaired this, they, this part of the Turin, the Shroud of Turin, probably contaminated with other substances. So when the they, one of them tried to verify, and when they take this piece of cloth, just do it like that and separate easily. So they conclude that was somebody trying to repair this part. So the carbon taste probably is the only test against the authenticity of the Shroud of Turin. So this is really an evidence than different kind of studies, because there is a different disciplines to try to look at them, because you can see chemicals, you can see textiles, you can see clothes, you can see physical reactions, you need photographers, you need a lot of equipment, a lot of people to try to study one things like that. So in different parts of the planet, they create groups of scientists to looking for the characteristics of the Shroud of Turin to verify that this is a real one, a real Shroud of Turin covered. But I'm pretty sure the different studies have the same conclusion. Because it's amazing, nobody can do something like that, because they don't find if this is not a pain. They are really sure that it's not a pain. And the positive reveal with Secondo Pia, who was in Italy in 19th century, who was the first person who took the pictures for the first time, and the image emerged, the real face of Jesus Christ emerged, and is really popular. You're looking in internet for Shroud of Turin, probably you're gonna find the first images that you can find. So as the image then Secondo Pia he took. So the other thing is the pollen, because they looking for, they found different piece of pollen, and a lot of those you can find those plants pollen in Asia and Jerusalem, who indicate those pollen belong on the, you can find what is the background of the Shroud of Turin. So other things that is really important is the wounds of Jesus Christ. So as a gospels, this gospel tells them have different wounds, one here in their hand, in his hands and his feet, here close to their ribs, has wounds. And in this Shroud of Turin, Shroud, you can find the same, this match with the Gospels tell us about the wounds of Jesus Christ. So we can find a lot of evidences about the authenticity of the Shroud of Turin. But probably for me, the most interesting thing is the type of blood is AB positive. So this is really important, because this kind of blood you can just found 1 in 2 billions of people. This kind of blood, I don't tell you the AB positive. I tell you about this kind of AB positive. I mean, just 1 in 1 million. So Sudarium Oviedo, Sudarium and Shroud of Turin, they match at the same, this is the same blood, AB positive. So I will read about the miracles of the Eucharist, the host. So because there is some of them, or most of them, when they examined it, they test, they found the same kind of blood. So we're telling you, I'm telling you, then this is really amazing. Really, when I saw this for first time, my life say, wow, my God, it's incredible how God loves us. How God trying to shows that he's with us. Some people don't believe because they said, I didn't see Jesus Christ. And I'm pretty sure some of us, you saw Jesus Christ in front of us, he appears close to us, we're gonna be like, oh my God, we're gonna, probably our freedom could be end as soon as we saw Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ just give us clues in different moments of the history of humans, history of the world. So I'm going to read the some of miracles. Then there you can find this blood test of amazing things. So I'm going to start with the miracle of Lanciano, 8th century. In the 8th century, a priest in Lanciano, Italy, was experiencing doubts about the real presence of Jesus in the Eucharist. In the middle of saying Mass, he said the words of consecration, "This is my body, this is my blood." And so the bread and wine transformed into real human flesh and blood. The blood coagulated into the 5 globules. Later, believed to be representative of 5 wounds of Jesus Christ. The word of the miracle quick spread. The local archbishop launched an investigation. The church approved the miracle. The flesh is still preserved to this day. Professor of anatomy Odoardo Linoli conducted a scientist analysis in flesh in 1971 and concluded that the flesh was cardiac tissues. The blood appeared to be fresh blood and opposed to the blood that was in 1200 years old, and there was no trace in preservatives. So keep going with other. You can see miracle flesh and blood in the church of San Francisco in Lanciano, Italy. other one called the Corporal of Bolsena, 13th century, a priest who had been experiencing doubts about the transubstantiation, was celebrating Mass in Orvieto, Italy. Soon after he had consecrated the Eucharist, the host started bleeding onto the corporal, a liturgical clot on the altar. The priest, the history goes, ran to the Pope, who was visiting the town, and confessed his sin about doubt. The corporal remains on display in the Cathedral of Oviedo. Some historians, however, question the veracity of the history, since the first accounts it don't appear until about 100 years after miracle supposed to took place. Nonetheless, the corporal remains an object of veneration. The third, the host of Siena, Italy, 18th century. On August 14, 1730, while the Catholics of Siena, Italy, were attending the special festival of the Eve of the Feast of the Assumption, thieves entered the Church of San Francisco and stole a golden ciborium contained hundreds of consecrated hosts. 2 days later, some noticed something white protruding from the offering box on another church in Siena. The priest opened the box and found the missing host inside, strangled in cobwebs and dirt. After being cleaned as much as possible, the host were placed in new ciborium and taken back into the church and Saint Francis for prayers and reparation and veneration. Since the hosts were dirty, the priest decided not to consume them, but let them simply deteriorate. Over the next few days, everyone was amazed to see that the hosts didn't not deteriorate, but actually appear fresh. The hosts remain in this state today, 85 years later, and can still be seen in now Basilica of San Francis of Siena, Italy. Fourth, the miracle of Chiratakonam, Indian. On April 28, 2001, there was an Eucharistic adoration in St. Mary's Parish of Chiratakonam, India, when suddenly three red stains materialized on their host. The priest didn't know what to do and placed the host back into the tabernacle. A few days later, he retrieved the host, examined it again, and the red stains had arranged themselves to look like the face of a man, Jesus. He quickly found the photographer and had pictures taken of the host. The fifth, the Eucharist miracle on Santarém, 13th century. A woman living in Santarém, Portugal, in the 13th, was distressed that her husband was unfaithful to her, and she decided to consult a sorceress for help. The sorceress told her the price of her service was consecrated host. She went to the Mass and the Church of the Stephen and received the Eucharist in her tongue, removed the Eucharist from her mouth, wrapped it through her belt, and hid it on the door of the church. But before she got out, the host began to bleed. When she got home, she put the bloodied host in a trunk. That night, a miracle light emanated from the trunk, and she repented of what she had done, and the next morning confessed to her priest. Her priest came and retrieved
the host and took it back to the church. After the investigation, approval of the miracle, the church was renamed Church of Holy Miracle, and the blood hosted remain displayed to this day. So there is some miracles, very interesting miracles that happened through the history of the Catholic Church. So the most important is this miracles is not the center of the faith. The center of the faith, of course, is Jesus Christ, but it's the presence of Jesus Christ. If we just silent, we keep silent, the Son cry out about the presence of God. So this is important message for today for the people, because we saw different statues of the Virgin Maria, or different of Jesus Christ that blended, or you can see some of them bleeding. And I don't say that all of them is true. Could be there is some fakes, but the scientists, some of them trying to verify what's going on, and with the scientist tools they tested and they verified that those kind of miracles are real. So I did two videos before. One was about the confession, the penitence. The other was about the communion, the Eucharist. And Jesus Christ, if you don't eat my flesh, you don't drink my blood, you don't have eternal life. So God invites us to follow His teaches. He teach us so about the what we have to do. So to confess, first of all, when we confess our sins with the priest, is one part of the examination of spiritual status, how state. So how we feel. If we feel dirty, we go over there to the mass and get the confession, and we clean our souls. So the other thing is important is take the body of Jesus Christ.